are no simple answers are there. But the truth should be upheld. The other day I read in the newspaper, a Hindu, a statement made by the Secretary General of the Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh. His name is Mrujesh Upadhyay. He was criticizing the government of India led by Narendra Modi. 70,000 crores were expected in the budgets through the sale of the PSU, public sector units of the country. He says it will be a disaster for the Indian public sector, for the working class of this country. He cited two examples. One, according to him, is the sale of the VS Sanjar, Videsh Sanjar Nigam Limited to Tata, a step taken by the government. The results were not promising. It was a decision on the wrong direction, he told. The other one he mentioned was the sale of Balco. That also he said, that's a failed attempt. So there are criticisms from Sangh Pajawal itself about the policy directions of this present government. And students as a section of Indian population, the most vital, vibrant, you are the people who make this country young. You are the people who make this country intelligent. You are the people who has to make a new India in the coming days. So look around you and understand the reality surrounding you. You should know that this budget, it talked a lot about three segments. One is women, one is poor, one is villages. Repeatedly they were telling villages are taken care of. Women are taken care of. Poor are taken care of. But only on ways. In deeds, nothing is being taken care of. The funny part of the budget can be seen in the speech of the Honorable Finance Minister. It has become a practice now. Finance ministers, at the last part of their budget speech, they will quote beautiful poems. He also did it, this time also. In his poem, there is one part which affected me. That is like this. If the winds are in our favor, if the winds are in our favor, it's very prophetic line. Then we will achieve, we will reach. There is an if there. If the winds are in our favor, we will reach there. That means 50% chances there that the winds may not be in our favor also. Let's all hope that the winds should be in India's favor. But hopes will not come true unless there are objective conditions for that. Objective conditions in the country, in the world, say that winds are not in our favor. Global predictions are saying that global economy is going to have a development, a growth rate might be less than 2%. Winds are not in our favor. Credit to say, you know, the students of economics may be knowing, they are telling that 10% of the Indian population are keeping with them 57% of the 57.8% of the total wealth of this country. Grama Rajyam, we call it. Socialist India, we call it. Poor are being taken care of, we claim it. In this country, Not a left document says. Credit Suisse says that this is the condition of this country. 10% at the higher echelons of society or the people operation, they keep with them almost 58% of the Indian brands. And that gap is of the Indians. You will be following the UNDP documents every year. UNDP year after year is telling on its human development reports that in the years of globalization, inequalities are on the increase. Within the countries, it increases. Between the countries, it increases. Things are not in our favor. And this is an age of an era of global warming. I very well believe that global warming and globalization should be understood not as entities of opposite origin. They have many things in common. Not the global part of it, not the spelling of it. Globalization and global warming are the results of profit mongering of the rich, of the rich. They created globalization. They should answer for the peril of the earth in the form of global warming. It's not a threat to anybody. It's a real danger looming on our future. Water is the real issue. The scarcest of the resources of this country. Every land in this country are paying for water. Without water, no agriculture, then no food, then no life. UNO has coined a phrase, this phrase of food refugees. Millions of people of this world will cross their country barriers and boundaries to go to any other places which they don't know in search of food. UNO is talking about another time, this phase of food rewards. Rewards may take place for food, for water. My dear friends, winds are not in our favor. Definitely.